It's the 50th anniversary of President John F. Kennedy's visit to the Northland. We talked to folks who were there, including one of our own.
Live from the WDIO broadcast studios, this is Eyewitness News at 10 on WDIO WIRT.
Good evening, I'm Darren Danielson. 50 years ago today, President John F. Kennedy stopped in the Northland. On this anniversary, residents in northern Wisconsin are celebrating how the president spurred conservation efforts that continue to maintain the natural beauty of our region today. Reporter Travis Dill begins our team coverage.
Darren, JFK flew over the Apostle Islands and the Chequamegon Bay in 1963. He called for their protection then, and today, area residents are celebrating the environmental stewardship that's lasted 50 years.
JFK Day brings over 200 people to the airport that bears his name in Ashland. But 50 years ago, 12,000 were here to see the president speak on the small tarmac.
There were just lots and lots of people. It was just crowded. People everywhere.
Kitty Weese was a senior in high school at the time and says she won't forget the historic event.
But it was really exciting to be here and come out to the airport and watch these helicopters fly in and the Secret Service people and Kennedy coming out.
That day, Kennedy spoke about protecting the natural resources of the area. But former Congressman Dave Obie says it never would have happened without the efforts of Senator Gaylord Nelson.
I don't believe you can understand the excitement of that day unless you understand the excitement that people like Gaylord Nelson and John Kennedy brought to politics.
Kennedy was assassinated just 2 months later, but Senator Nelson worked for 7 years until the Apostle Islands Lakeshore became a protected national park. Weese says she wasn't worried about the environment as a high schooler, but now she's thankful for the conservation efforts.
We go sailing around the islands, and to know that that's a national park and everyone can be there to enjoy it, yeah, I think that's very nice.
The crowd cheers as speakers tout the environmental accomplishments of the last 50 years. And Kennedy's vision is something residents hope to protect for generations to come.
The politicians speaking at the event today say the environmental reforms took bipartisan support.
Right.
Darren, a Democratic Congress passed the legislation, but Republican President Richard Nixon signed it into law.
That's right, Travis. Thank you very much for that. And one of our own actually had the chance to be there when JFK visited Duluth. Longtime WDIO WIRT news anchor Dennis Anderson was there as a teenager from Virginia starting his news career. He shared his memories with reporter Maria Anderson today.
Internal Revenue Service employee,
members of local.
Most of you remember Dennis Anderson as the face and voice of WDIO for decades. But before he was behind the desk, he was a young radio reporter on the Iron Range.
I put 50 years in journalism, and I was 2 years into the career when President Kennedy got here. So I was a very young man.
He was 19 and covering the arrival to the Duluth International Airport of President John F. Kennedy.
It was big.
As a radio reporter, Denny was armed with tape recorders, but he also brought his movie camera.
The film I took of President Kennedy Duluth was shot with just a simple little 8mm movie camera that I had gotten for a Christmas present a year or two earlier.
Denny says that September day in 1963 was a rainy one, but it didn't dampen the spirits of the crowd. They all cheered as Air Force One came into sight.
And when he got here, three things struck my mind. I was amazed at how young he looked. I was amazed how thin he was, and I was amazed at the size of the crowd, or mostly how jubilant the crowd was.
Just 2 months later, JFK was assassinated, and Denny says it was felt close to home.
I think when Duluth heard that President Kennedy was assassinated, they had people here in town had a special link with him. Because he was here, so many people saw him here.
And over Denny's career, several other presidents would visit the Northland, but he says that first visit from President Kennedy was a special one.
So it brought Washington to life in Duluth, and I think that's what a lot of people felt, that it's more than just a picture on a television screen. Hey, this is real.
In Duluth, I'm Mari Anderson for Eyewitness News.
Of course, Denny has covered thousands of stories during his 50-year career and has a hard time picking a favorite, but he says seeing President Kennedy as a 19-year-old reporter made quite an impression on him. Well, as we saw in that report, it was rainy and windy in Duluth 50 years ago today, but it sure wasn't today. Let's bring in Justin Lyles now for our first weather forecast.
I was 19 when I first saw Denny. I'm just kidding. He's going to kill me. I wasn't quite that young, but anyway, we had temperatures out there that were